We know that rasa siddhanta is the bedrock of Indian aesthetics, and it is vastu tantram, not purusha tantram or kartu tantram. Those who are well aware of the works of Adi Shankara, they know these two terms. One of the wonderful terms coined by Shankara and given for us, Vastu Tantram and Purusha Tantram. Rasa is Vastu Tantra. And not Purusha Tantra or Karta Tantra. Vastu Tantra is like the sweetness of honey or any edible dish which has sweetness. And Karta Tantra or Purusha Tantra, these are conventions man made. This is natural and this is unnatural. Means rasa as ananda, rasa as ananda. It is Vastu Tantra, but not Purusha Tantra or Kartra Tantra. It is not an imagination, it is not a convention. For example, Kavisamaya, when Shankar discussed, it is a convention, it is Kartra Tantra. In every region, every poetry, for example, in the Western tradition, moon is in feminine gender. And like our Kirti or Yashas is white in color, there jealousy is green in color. And there anger is red in color. Here love is red in color. So like that, these are some differences which we make. But enjoyment is not a notion, is not an imagination, is not hallucination, is not a convention, is not assumption, it is experience. And hence, it is Vastu Tantra. And that is why it is very, very important. So is the thing, that is emotion, which we all feel, bhava. And rasa is vaguely translated into English as art experience. Both capitals, vaguely translated, while bhava is emotion. And here, vastu rasa is neither created nor destroyed, it is realized. Can we create energy? No. We can only realize that. We can only reveal it. Likewise, rasa is that. Always we have that ananda. But we need certain agencies to trigger that. Energy is available everywhere. But we have to have a source. We have to have a system to tap it. Then comes hydroelectric power, then comes thermoelectric power, thermal power, then tidal, wind, so many such things. So also, here, the light has to glow means we need a circuit, something like that. So we need a sequence, we need a system to trigger rasa. We are not producing rasa. Nahi rasaha utpadyate. Rasa eva, rasa kevalam nishpadyate. Nishpatti means it is revelation, not creation. Anything created has to destroy. But it is realization, hence it is not created, it is not impermanent. It is permanent, but its realization will be temporary. Its existence is permanent, but its realization is temporary. For this, we have a method. Bharata Muni is the first seer who has explored and explained the feature of rasa. And the Rasa Sutra in the 6th chapter, Tatra Vibhavanubhava Vyavichari Sanyoga Drasanishpatti. Here, he gives a cryptic statement. Rasa is revealed through the synthesis of Sanyoga, synthesis of Vibhava, Anubhava, Vyabhichari Bhava, Sanyogat. By the synthesis of Vibhava, Anubhava and Vyabhichari Bhavas, Rasa is revealed. From where? From our own being. And that he hasn't mentioned but implied. Because I told in the earlier discourses itself, in the very first day, Rasa is the sublimated aspect of Bhava. When Bhavas get sublimated, they become Rasa. Bhavas are something like the opaque colors. Rasas are like the transparent color. And I had written the diagram also, how in the retort, the murky water, the worldly emotions, they become distilled, that is Rasa. They're losing their color, taste, contamination, and becoming pure, sane and healthy. So is that. And here we have Vibhava. Vibhavas, Anubhavas, Vibhichari Bhavas, and there is one more thing, Sattvika Bhava. And here, yet another thing, Sthayi Bhava. But in the Rasa Sutra, only these three are mentioned. These two are not. I shall tell you the reason also. Vibhava means, Vibhava is of two kinds. One is Alambana. Alambana. And another is Uddipana. Alambana Vibhavas and Uddipana Vibhavas. Vibhava means the object which is very essential, the nucleus around which the whole of the things, they revolve around, and they are of two kinds. Vibhavyate bhavaha asmin. Alambana, the primordial, and Uddipana, the catalytic, they who encourage, they which encourage, they come and they accelerate, they quicken, and they deepen, they intensify, such things. And Anubhavas are the physical manifestations. And Vyabhichari Bhavas are the transitory emotions. And Sthayi Bhava are the latent, permanent emotions, dominating, dormant emotions which are present. I shall repeat once again. Sthayi Bhava, Sthayi means permanent. Permanent emotions present in us, which are very strong and independent. Which are strong, distinguishable, independent, dormant, latent, which are always present. And then Vyabhichari Bhavas are similar to Sthayi Bhava, but not in quantity. They are variations. They come and go. They are present, but their appearance is transitory in nature. They come and go. To give one example, if Sthayi Bhava is rice or roti, Vyabhichari Bhavas are something like side dishes. They may come and go. They may differ in quantity like that. And then Vibhava is the things which are outside. The Sthayi Bhavas and Vyabhichari Bhavas are within. The Vyabhichari Bhava is within the Sahradaya.
within the Sahrudaya, the connoisseur. So there within the Sahrudaya.
While Vibhavas are outside. And Anubhavas and Vyabhichari Bhavas, Anubhavas, they are within and beyond. When Anubhavas are within the Sahrudaya, during the time of art experience, they manifest as sattvika bhavas. When they are within the external objects, means poetry, art form or whatever, they express in a different way. So this you must remember. And here I am giving a sort of a cause and effect. Vibhava is cause. Anubhavas are effects. I shall tell you. Vibhava means you have delicious ice cream which is seen in the counter. Immediately your mouth is watering. Then that is the Anubhava. This is the Vibhava and here is the Anubhava. And then why I have made these two classifications? Alambana Vibhava may be ice cream. Uddipana Vibhava is a summer thirsty feeling within me, and I have money. All these things will promote my desire for that. So Alambana Vibhava is the main trigger, external trigger, and Uddipana Vibhava are the associative factors. So here is the cause and there is the effect. Why not write simpler way, cause and effect, karana and karya, instead of uddipana vibhava, anubhava, vibhava, so many new terminologies, that question may arise. It's because the four process of art experience is not worldly, not vyavaharika. It is emotional, it is artistic, it is not connected with the material world, and that's why these new terms are used. It is alaukika or lokottara for that purpose. That's what Abhinav Gupta answers when discussing this equation. Now, I shall give an example and show how they act upon. Take a poem. All of us know Shakuntala. All of us know Gita Govinda, where Krishna and Radha are in love with each other. Now Radha is in deeply love with Krishna. Krishna becomes Alambana Vibhava. Her love entirely depends upon Krishna. Krishna is the main trigger of her love. And Uddipana Vibhava, the beautiful banks of Jamuna, and then the dense forest there, the lush green bushes there, the wonderful creepers there, the flowers there, the beautiful spring season or autumn or whatever, and also the moonlight, all these things, and the cool breeze, and then utter freedom, independence, privacy, secrecy, all these things they act upon as Uddipana Vibhava. It is something like if you have milk, if cardamom is added, if kesar is added, sugar is added, how delicious it will be, how enjoyable it will be, so are the Uddipana Vibhava. And thus, to Radha, all of us should feel that we are Radha. Then, Alambana Vibhava is Krishna. Uddipana Vibhava is the ambience. Then what Radha feels about Krishna? When she sees Krishna, her eyes are wide opened. And her hands move towards him to embrace, hug him. And the feet, they run towards him. And at the same time, she may feel shy. She may close her face. And she may start twisting her nails. She may start laughing at him, chiding at him. She may start rather ridicule him, why you came late, something like that. So many such things, they manifest on the body. They are the anubhavas. Oh, go Krishna, like that. She says, automatically, go means, with the word, the hand also comes, the face also says, come. So much of change, it occurs at the body. The psychosomatic changes that occur, they are anubhavas. And in the mind, the deep love for Krishna, that is rati, enjoyment, that is this thai bhava, that is there. And also, that is supported with the vyabhichari bhavas. Vyabhichari bhavas are many. Thai bhavas according to 8. Vyabhichari bhavas are 33. Sattvika bhavas are 8. The number is not important, but this much is true. Totally, 8 plus 33, 41 plus 8 is 49. This is the list what Bharata gives. The number is again not important, but Bharata has deeply studied this. He had a great tradition as well, and he has come to this number, though arbitrary, with lot of research that we should never ignore. In our tradition, there may be some not exact, not that exact, not that precise numbers or some information, but even then they are product of great wisdom and great observation, and so they are not easy numbers. To challenge them, we should have sufficient stuff also. Well, even then the number is not important. The Vyabhichari Bhavas are so many. Lajja, Bhaya, Nidra, Tandra, Harsha, like that, so many are there. Shyness, fear, morosiveness, excitement, and then jealousy. So many such things are there. In one Shringara, everything can be shown. That is the most wonderful rasa. One friend of mine here, last night, the guest house, when we were talking to each other, he told me, why can't you share your experience, how you became this yourself? There is nothing great about it. But as one passing reference, I can say, I was strong advocate of Shantarasa, staunch advocate of Shantarasa and anti-Shringara, thinking that Shringara is erotism. And in my college days, when I started learning Sanskrit, I wanted to whitewash Shringara, demolish Shringara and establish Shanta. For that purpose, I started reading and studying aesthetics. When slowly I started reading, I realized there is no difference between Shringara and Shanta. If you connect, that is Shringara. If you disconnect, that is Shanta. That's all. If you connect to the world and then observe it, it is Shringara. If you disconnect with the world and observe, then it is Shanta. That Shringara, which is not leading to Shanta, is not Shringara. It is voluptuousness, that is Kama. At the same time, vulgarity. That Shanta, which has not realized the beauty of Shringara, is lifelessness, unhuman. Both are true. That I had the realization. So many times we get biased. Why? In my college days, I used to ridicule, who is Kalidasa? Though I hadn't read him deeply, it was some ignorance, some foolishness. Everybody praised Kalidasa. Why I should praise him? This bohemian attitude will be there. Iconoclastic mind will be there. No. Why I should agree with that? I should shun. I should challenge. So whenever somebody says Kalidasa is good, oh, what Kalidasa, why not you see that poet, this poet, something like that. I had read here and there so many other poets by that time. And also, Shakuntala was our text. There, in the context, verses will be beautiful. Out of context, they may not mean much. You see, if you isolate one seasoning, what you do for food, for vegetables or curries or whatever, if you isolate it in a dish, can we eat it? In the same way, if you isolate one ingredient into in one cooking one dish separately, can you relish? No. If you isolate one note from a swara, can you enjoy? I like boop very much. But if I isolate Rishabha or Gandhara or Daivata, can I enjoy? No. So as a whole, I have to see, not having understanding of all these things, oh, this verse isolated is very poor, I can write better, something like that. When I slowly started going deeper into Kalidasa, that happened through Meghadutam and Raghuvamsham. In Raghuvamsham 16th canto, poet describes how was the great empire Ayodhya went to oblivion and got ignored and it got ruined after the demise of Rama, after the heavenly departure of Rama. How was the Ayodhya? How is the Ayodhya? The contrast he brings, that section, that 16th chapter, that opened my eyes. By the same time, the Purumegha of Kalidasa, the cloud messenger poem, the course of journey from central India to Himalaya, a wonderful journey, those 60 verses and odd, they opened my eyes. From then onwards, I started confessing myself in public whenever I wanted to speak on Kalidasa. Yat kaishore kritam anuchitam nirvishankam hatasham tvat kavyanam laghu nirasanam jalpato melpa buddhya smaram tava shivakriti ranvaham tannu kuryam prayaschittam kavikulaguro lajjaya kajjalakshah. I have washed my eyes with tears of apology, tears of correcting my error, and I have got new vision of knowing you. What I did in my adolescence, how foolishly I did, please forgive me for this arrogance and that haughtiness. And now I am here compassionately looking at you, respectfully looking at you, oh master of poets. That is the meaning of this verse. This verse I composed and started reciting any beginning of any of my Kalidasa lectures, because it should never be forgotten in my mind. I was so. And anybody, if he is treading the course what I did long ago, that should be a warning to him, that should be a guidance to him, like that. So, in such cases, isolation is not of any use. It should be holism that is very, very important. And here, coming to the Vyabhichari Bhavas, this Lajja, Amarsha, Harsha, everything connected with Shringara. Shringara has abundant scope for all these. Why? I shall deal with the Rasa and Purushartha, that is basic values of life, at the next instance. Anubhavas are Karya. No. Vibhava. When vibhavas arise, then the anubhavas come out. Sthayi bhava by itself will not do anything. But the vibhavas, they inspire us and we react. The reaction at the body level, psychosomatic reaction to the vibhavas is anubhava. And then, among the purusharthas, don't get misunderstood that Purusharta is male chauvinism. No. In our tradition, Purusha means Jiva. Jiva has no gender. In Sanskrit language, the words have a gender which is not at all connected with the things. Wife is represented by three words having three genders. Dharaha, masculine. And then Kalatram, feminine. Bharya, Patni, feminine. So all the three are there. Word and gender have no connection. The gender of the thing to, which is designated by the word has no connection. Even then, Puri Shete iti Purushaha, that which dwells in the body is Purusha. And so Purushartha means Purushaha Arthyate Anena. Yetehi Purushaha Arthyate iti Purushartha. That is the value system through which we realize ourselves is called Purushartha. And that has nothing to do with gender bias. So, among the Purusharthas, I am leaving aside the moksha, the three worldly Purusharthas, Dharma, Artha, Kama, Artha and Kama. Kama is desire.
Artha is the agency which quenches the desire earlier mentioned. And dharma is the order needed. Because if there is no order, my artha, my resources may be snatched away by others. So I may not be able to fulfill my kama. And that's why dharma is the order. There comes some snacks. And all of us rush there. If we are 40 people here, if there are 40 pieces, everybody will be getting one. If somebody grabs three, two people will be losing that. So people would say, no, please have one a piece. Something like that, an order is established. Dharma is such a type of order, such a nature thing, dharma, sustenance. And so, dharma and artha, in the worldly sense, they work for kama. And kama is the real enjoyment. If not, we can accelerate earning artha because we want to earn fast. We cannot earn slow. Or sometimes we are compelled to earn slow. Orders may be faster or slower, but enjoyment takes its own pace. I told earlier, we cannot fast forward a 1 hour CD to half an hour or elongate it to 2 hours. Enjoyment should take its own course. If I take 20 minutes to have my lunch or dinner, I have to take 20. If I fast forward that by 10 minutes, my satisfaction will not be there. I will not be relishing the food. In that sense, kama is the essence of the three purusharthas in the worldly sense. And that's why, based on that, we have Shringara. And in Shringara, we'll be seeing a lot of such emotions. Even today, much of our art is based on that. In the name of bhakti, again the madhura bhakti, Shringara alone reigns supreme. In Shringara, you can show all rasas. I shall discuss that later, but this much you remember. If I forget the concept, forget that particular detailing, then you please remind me, so I shall elaborate Shringara, because many dancers are there. For dance, it is the bread and butter. Not to speak about literature as well. Anandavardhana, the great aesthetician, says, Shringari chet kavik kavye jatam rasamayim jagat sa eva vitaragas chet sarvam nirasam eva tu Shringara eva mudra param prahladano rasaha. Bhoja too says, Shringara eva rasaiti rasanamam rasamam namaha. So, Shringara is the rasa, rasa raja. And the Lord of Sustenance, Mahavishnu, reads the rasa Shringara according to Natishastra. Here, the Vyabhichari Bhavas of the Rati, the love, deep love in the hearts of Radha, Vyabhichari Bhavas are many. Lajja is one such. Oh, Krishna is coming, how to face him? Till Krishna comes, why he didn't came? That is the earnest desire of Radha. When he comes, how to stare at him? That is another difficulty. There is one beautiful verse in Amarukshataka. Astam Vishvasanam Sakishu Vidita Bhipraya Sarejane Katrapyarpaitum Drisham Surchiram Shaknomi Novridaya Lokopyesha Paropahasa Chituraha Sukshmingi Tagnopyalam Mataha Kam Sharanam Vrajami Hridaye Jirnonu Raga Analaha. One girl who is in love with somebody is telling to an elderly person, mother or somebody, well, you say that I should have revealed my love and shared my love and said about my love with my friends. Let alone with my friends, I am unable to reveal my love in front of my lover also. Astam Vishvasanam Sakishu Viditabhipraya Sarejane. They know my heart. Let alone sharing with my friends. Tatrapi arpaitum drisham suruchiram shaknomi no leelaya, no vridaya. I can't even stare at my lover because of shyness. In that case, how can I reveal all these things to my friends? So it's not possible. It's something like kissing the microphone. So, lokopyesha paropahasa sulabhaha sukshmengi tajnopyalam. And the world around is very suspicious and also very keen in knowing the mannerisms and activities of others and even gossip about us. That's why I don't want to reveal. Mataha kam sharanam vrajami. Who mother, where shall I go? And whom shall I beg and whom shall I pray? Hridaye jirnaha anuraga analaha. The fire of love
is putting off in my heart itself, is put off in my heart, is being lost, is becoming cold. Amaruka is one of the finest poets. At least to read him, one should learn Sanskrit. Well, here it is the desperation that is the mood. And Radha feels like that. How to reveal my love to Krishna, that is the shyness. And anxiety, kathara, whether he will turn out or not, whether he will accept my love or not. And jealousy, he is flirting with other people, he was talking to her, he was looking to her, he was moving with her, what will happen to me? So all these things, they come as vyabhichari bhavas. You know how it will be enriched, the sthayi bhava. And then, when that is being written in poetry, or danced on the stage, or filmed and screened on the screen, big screen, or if that is painted or sculpted in different medium, or sung in the form of raga and tala, what happens? The sthayi bhava of us also has love. All of us, irrespective of our status, irrespective of our status of any sort, will be having the basic emotions. But some people at some time may not be having. For example, a child of 5 may not be having love in the heart. It has to manifest. It should find a time and maturity. Like that, a person who has withdrawn from the world may not have love, ratibhava, for Shringara. But all of us at one time or the other in our lifetime would have felt all these bhavas for a sufficient span of time. And based on this reality, Rasa Siddhanta is established, not on the whims and fancies of any person with beard, any person with jata juta, any person with basma and all that. Our tradition is not a blind tradition. It's a profound tradition of awareness, understanding, contemplation, and magnanimity. Now, the great seer Bharata has realized that all of us have the basic emotions. When they get a vent, they are revealed. I think some of you would have read popular pulp fiction of James Hadley Chase. Have you not? Yeah. There in one of his novels, he says, every man is a criminal until he is caught. Likewise, all of us have all bhavas until a vent is given for the gushing outpour of that. So that is the vibhava. And in poetry, in the world, when it happens, we have sthayi bhavas. That is, for all the purpose, it is one. Whether we enjoy it or not, all of us have sthayi bhavas. When we see an object, a boy, a college-going boy, looks at a girl, college-going girl, he develops rati, but not shringara rasa. Because he has a material purpose. You see, if I look at a painting which pictures a cup of water, I will not become thirsty. If I am not in a mood to enjoy when I am thirsty, I may not look at it. But just because it is written, going there and taking it, a child may do, I will not do. So, art piece by nature will not evoke any sort of material response from the connoisseurs. If such is reciprocated, then he is not or she is not a connoisseur. In a film, the hero is coming by BMW, if I think that I should possess that, in that moment I am not a connoisseur. I am just making window shopping in a mall where the cars are being sold. I am not in the cinema hall, though the cinema hall is located in a mall. So, when our worldly desires appear, then that is not the art for that moment, and we are not the artist for that moment. Please.
Okay.
have not come to rasa. Let me explain about rasa and then the question will be answered. Rasa is not a strange thing. Rasa is not an alien which will be coming from a spaceship, in a spaceship and enter into our heart. This Thaya Bhava itself sublimates into rasa. All of us, before we encounter with an art piece, we have Thaya Bhavas. When once the art of our choice appears, and when once we start relishing it, this Thaya Bhava sublimates as rasa. Got it? So, please. I shall come to it. Wonderful. The sattvic bhavas are also felt by Radha. Why Krishna is not coming? She is shuddering. The shiver that comes, that is what we have kampa. Why Krishna is not coming? She is sweating. Sveda is there. Oh, Krishna has come, blushing. Vaivarnya is there. Krishna, like that she says, that is Vaisvarya, the voice has changed. Krishna has come, the horripilation is seen, Romancha. All are, oh, Krishna didn't came, faint. Then Pralaya is also there. So, Radha as a human being faces that. And we, while watching, we may also feel that. If we could feel that, then the rasa and the realization of rasa is to the brim. When the sattvic bhava is felt, we start, without our knowledge, tears come. We get horripilated and we feel romancha and vaivarni. All these things will happen, and in the excessive joy, we may also go fainted. That also be possible. But to that extent, I have not. But stambha, sveda, romancha, ashru, vaivarni, all these things I have felt. And most of us would have felt while beholding very good art. Now, all these things, when a poet writes, I shall take an example. Krishna is going to Mathura. He will not be coming back. What will be the fate of Radha? And Radha is waiting for Krishna on the banks of Yamuna. Tomorrow morning he will be leaving. Tonight I have to meet him. She is waiting and waiting and waiting. The person, Akrura, the most Krura human being on earth, will be... He is the messenger from Kamsa and he will be taking away Krishna. What to do? Then somehow Krishna makes some time for Radha and comes. Then she says, Maga ityapamangalam. Oh Krishna, please don't go if I say it's inauspicious. Vrajakila, you go. Snehena shunyam bachaha. There is nothing like affection in that word. If I say go, well, you want to go to Mathura? Yes, well, go. Tishta, you stay here. This is Prabhuta. In love, domination cannot occur. If there is domination, then love is gone. Tishteti prabhuta yatharuchi kurushva. It's a wonderful, tactful way. That's what modernists often do. Very objectively, I should give your own space and all that. Yatharuchi kurushva. You do as you like. The modern convenience of mediocrity in the name of etiquette, all such things, not intervening, every such thing, very decent and polite, lifeless, spineless thing to say, the least. Yatha ruchi kurishva, you do as you like. Snehena shunyam vachaha. There is nothing there, no love there. No jivami vinatvayeti vacharam sambhavyate vanava. Oh Krishna, without you I can't live. Like the 70s or 65s Hindi films, Tamil films, Telugu films. Oh, I can't live without you. I will die like that. If I say, it's melodramatic. Even after your departure, if I live, what else greater sin and what else greater humiliation than this? Tanmam shikshaya Krishna yatsamuchitam vakyam tvayit prasthite. Here is the poetry. Oh, Krishna, please do me one thing. You teach me what should I say when you are going away. The Alvida word, the goodbye word, please teach me, let me do that. This is what Radha is going to say. Having heard this poem, are you not feeling Shringara? Are you not feeling the bhava of Radha? Tell me yes or no. The love in you has manifested as Shringara Rasa.
And then the anxiety of Radha, the pain of Radha, the Katara, Glani, Ashru, Vaivarnya, all these things are felt. So, according to our capacity to enjoy, because when wind blows, whether it is a small blade of grass or a big tree, they oscillate and proportionally they also reciprocate. Likewise, our chitta samskara, accordingly we reciprocate. That happens, and here is that. Our sthayi bhava, because we are not having any personal interest with Radha. If we support Radha, Radha will not be paying any 1,000 rupees or 10,000 coins of gold, nothing. No such profit, no such loss. So no personal gain or no personal loss. It is without our knowledge happening that. And this way of our own love getting sublimated, that is called rasa. And in this case, it is Shringara rasa. And this is happening because, having heard this verse, if you rush to Yamuna and want to search Radha and say, I will fetch Krishna for you, over involvement. Oh, this Ganesh is a mad person. I say he's saying something, some other thing. All this is mumba jumbo. Who cares about Radha? Was Radha a living person or not? In that way, casually, if he starts sitting and watching, then also there is no rasa. Over involvement also mars rasa as under involvement. Optimum involvement is very, very important. This is what we feel. In a drama, Lanka Dahana is going on. Hanuman is burning Lanka. Then, are we compassionate? Are we jubilant? What? Do we rush to the stage to quench the fire that is burning? No. How beautifully Lanka is burnt, we say. You mean to say that are we sadists? No. When Harishchandra's wife Chandramati or Taramati, also another name of her, she has lost son. She is coming to the burial yard in Harishchandra, that is Harishchandra Ghat of Varanasi. In the burial yard, she is coming and to have the last rite of her son. But nobody is there to help. She is screaming, weeping and all that. She is singing in a very, very pathetic Shubhapantu Varali, that is the Todi Raga of Hindustani music. And singing, oh son, Lohitashva, how come you are bitten by snake and you are lost? Then, what beautiful thing, what a wonderful thing, that's what we enjoy. Are we sadistic? Are we taking advantage of the poor lady who has lost the son? No. We are not cruel people. At the same time, jumping onto the stage, oh mother, don't worry about your son. Let me take him to hospital and detoxify him. As the leftists say, detoxification of our syllabus. Like that, we shall do it. Or I will pay money for the last rites of your son. No such over-involvement is there. A rasika will be having optimum involvement, and that is what Rasa Siddhanta says. This way of ideal involvement, having compassion, and this is what a real jnani in the world will have. Please.
Yesterday you mentioned about the Draupadi Vastra
and the audience. Yes, 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 yes. Exactly. Wonderfully, you have caught me on the lips. There, according to Shuddha Natyashastra and Abhinogupta opinion, it is not 100% rasa, it is bhava. Except a very, very wonderful way of looking at things. I really congratulate you. Bharata is very, very intelligent. He had anticipated your birth. And that's why such questions may arise, and so has ensured. There he says, rasabhava nirantaram. At times, in art experience, we involve a bit. And a bit of involvement makes this reaction. Rasa, and also at times bhava. And that's why sometimes we become personal with art. Apart from loving the art, we start loving the artist also to an extent. And that's why fan clubs have come to existence. But truly speaking, highly rasika will not do. Will not do. But the bhava sparsha is there. Here and there it will come. Because Rasa Bhava, there is nothing like a strong demarcation. You all know, in the process of metallurgical extraction, the ore is there and a flux. For example, if iron has to be smelted from hematite, as flux will be using lime, both will be mixed in the cupola furnace and it will be burnt, it will be heated, and then the flux mixes and then it will reduce hematite into iron, and then the other oxides connected with lime, and that oxide layer floats as slag, and we tap out the slag. Slag will be floating above and it will be skimmed out, and below, because iron is heavy, it will be tapped down. While doing so, an element of slag will enter into it. We know certain admixture will be there, but Shate Panchashanyaya, it is pure. That's how we theoretically consider. Here and there it will be. Because you know, please.
Yeah, in connection with the same question, when we sometimes we cry in the movies. So is it rasa or bhava?
No, it is sattvika bhava, ashru. I mentioned that. Sattvika bhava. But if you start weeping instead of sobbing very much, then the bhava has dominated. The shoka bhava has dominated instead of karuna rasa. If naturally tears roll from our eyes, it is sattvika bhava. Involuntary emotions which pour out naturally. If you start weeping for a while, then it is shoka bhava that has come into picture.
What is in the case of catharsis and what happens there?
Catharsis.
Yeah.
Catharsis is similar to Rasa Siddhanta, and Abhinugupta's mentor, Bhattatuta, he was the person who taught this Rasa Siddhanta and Artishastra to Abhinugupta. Unfortunately, his work is lost. I have compiled all the fragments of Bhattatuta and trying to make writing of that. And there he says, when we indulge with art enjoyment, that is art experience, then the worldly emotions which are present in the characters and all, even in ourselves, they will be cleansed. How? We have a vessel which is murky, and you take some powder, washing powder, vessel washing powder, and then smear it, rub it. This is also murk. That is also murk. One murk will remove the other murk. So two negatives make one positive like that. One wrong emotion within us will be wiped off by the another wrong emotion, something like that. In catharsis, the same technique is told by Aristotle, where our emotions will be evacuated, will be poured out. Our emotions means here the bhavas will come out, and the coming out of the bhavas will be in the form of rasa that he hasn't mentioned. He says, by looking at the tragedy, pity and fear, they arise in our heart. And that always haunts us, bhaya and shoka, to say specifically. And in Bhagavad Gita, clearly Krishna says, kachideta shrutam partha tvaye kagrena chetasa kachid ajnana sammoha pranashtaste parantapa then nashto mohaha smritir labdha tvatprasadan mayachutaha titosmi gata sandeha karishye vachanam tava. The answer of Arjuna. Then bhayashoka samudha chetaha. Shankar Bhagavad Pada in the Bhashya clearly says, bhayashoka, these bhayashokas have to be overcome. And there, in a tragedy, looking at such a great person, because of one tragic flaw, all his life was doomed. How pitiful it is, and how scary it is. That's what we feel. And those emotions come out. These two always haunt us, and they are the seeds of our insecurity. That moment, we'll be losing that insecurity. But Aristotle has not clearly done all these things. He stops at one. I have improvised upon that based on the theory of rasa. Please.
Sir, among the vyabhichari bhavas, we have marana, smriti, nidra. How can sleep, memory, death, all these be considered as emotions?
Wonderful question. All these
come to us, but birth will not come to us. That's why Janma is not there. All that come at the level of emotion, act upon emotion, they are considered as Vyabhichari Bhavas. Anything that acts upon emotion within us, they are treated as Vyabhichari Bhavas.
So if
bhakti is a cultivate, because it is not in our hands. We are already born. Death, we are awaiting for. Please.
What is the difference between sattvika bhava and anubhava?
Anubhava is a fleeting moments of emotion that can be controlled. I have jealousy, yet I control. I have lajja, shyness, yet I control. But horripilation cannot be controlled. Tears cannot be controlled. Blushing cannot be controlled. If I say something to Arjun, immediately his face becomes red. He cannot control, but he can control his words. So some are involuntary and some are voluntary. Voluntary, involuntary cannot be controlled. Voluntary can be controlled because we have command over that. And that's why they are separated. And when we lose our control, what we are, that is our reality. If we conceal, we are always clever enough to conceal. But in spite of our attempts to conceal, if it goes to futility, then what arises, that is sattva. Because that is our nature, sat, existence, and the nature sattva, and connect with that is sattvika.
So involuntary is sattvika and anubhava.
Yes, exactly. Please.
Sir, anubhavas are effects.
Yes. Yes, naturally. But because they are involuntary, it is a separate category. Please.
How is sleep an emotion?
Huh?
How is nidra an emotion?
Because in acting, in such thing, they can be presented as well. As a human natural activity, they can be presented. And also, though we lose all our emotions there, the others will be there to getting affected by that. If he is a snoring person, having full of sound in his sound sleep, for such cases. Well, please.
Sir, in that Radha example that you gave, I was tending towards Karuna rather than Singha. How is it that you...
Because, you are feeling for Radha, you didn't become Radha. If you had become Radha, even that Karuna, yes, it is there, Karuna is certainly there because it is love in separation, Vipralambha Shringara. It is dominated by Karuna, but the trigger for that is in love. See, when a mother loses a child, it is full of Karuna. But when a lover is going away, then it is Vipralambha. But when the lover is dead, it becomes Karuna. Because the lover is still living, there is one hope that we may reunion after some time. When there is hope, pratyasha is there, then vipralambha is not karuna. When pratyasha is not there, there is no hope of meeting, that can happen only in death. Then it is karuna. Even in living condition, if there is absolutely no hope, which is a rarity, because we don't lose hope.
But
In some context, in the same context, some people may feel Karuna and some people may feel certainly. How do you explain? Because Shastra has an explanation. I shall answer that.
You said that Nidra is represented in art and different ways, like in art, Natya or in art.
Yes, all the activities are there. Metabolism is always there. Any such emotion triggers act and it is always there. Anubhava, we have, in the anubhava, so many activities are present. When you are shy, you cover the face. When you are angry, you move your body like this. So all the activities also are presented. Body-centric, all are body and mind-centric, not away. And the rest of the world goes to Uddipan Vibhava and Alambana Vibhava. Bharata is very, very shrewd. has accommodated everything.
So birth can be accommodated in different bhava, you are saying?
No. It can be certainly it can be accommodated. It can be accommodated. Putrotsava is there among the Ashtadasha Varnanas. And coming to your question, people can feel different emotions for the same situation. It is because of the vasanas that work behind sthai. Vasana means our conditioning. We are our conditioning. We are our biases. Our emotions are colored by our biases. So according to the vasana, the shades will go. But one thing is true, this is red and that is red, and then here is red and blood red is there, rose red is there. There are so many types of reds. Only a painter can distinguish which are the reds. But commonly it is red what we say. So the generality is there, and we should never forget that Shastra is standardization. It's a generic thing, not too specific a thing. If you try to make it verily customized and specific, it loses ease. Ease means one person should be able to handle it very easily. Our Shastrakaras are so keen in this. I think Professor Varkedi sir can understand that. In Chandas, we have Ganas. Yamata, Rajabhana, Salagam, Ragana, Igana, Jagana, like that. Why not instead of three Gurus or Lagus in three combination, why not four? It can be done. Then the Gana number will be very much. Why not two? The Gana number will be too small. Three is a group, two is a pair, and four is crowd. And minimum in a group should be three, and it will be easy for handling. While giving the Lakshana, if you have 16 Ganas appear, if you have four. 16 Ganas means the Lakshana will become, the Ganas number will become more difficult to remember. If you have two pairs, Guru Guru, Lagu Lagu, Lagu Guru, or Guru Lagu, only four means, in a Lakshana, you have to use, when you have Rana Ra, we have Ratodhata Smrita, Rana Ra, we have Ratodhata Smrita, like that. In three or four letters you can make it, you may have to use more. So the Gaurava, Laghava in Lakshanikarana, thinking all that, they arrived at the optimum. Like that, here also, the optimum nature of the Shastra is very much restored, and for that, the generalization has been done. Now we shall conclude this session, and I am very happy that so many of you are interested. Not in any such session, we had so many questions. All are very pertinent questions. All are intelligent questions. So let us discuss about that tomorrow.